James is going to speak to y'all today about that, and I want you to give him all your attention. I want you to receive from him, listen, put it in your bag here, because he's going to give you some golden nuggets that you're going to remember in college and when you start your career. So I want to hear a warm warrior welcome for James Koulanis. Yeah!
How you doing? How you doing?
Yeah!
I tell you what, let's return that with a great performance. Let's give Hashimi another round of applause. Yeah! All right. It's always a pleasure being invited to Fall Brook. This is my third, fourth time being here. So I feel like I'm part of the family. And I feel like you all are my family. Okay. One thing I want you all to know about myself is, first of all, I'm an artist, author, wrote a couple of books, got a couple of them out here, entrepreneur, etc. But most importantly, I am a parent. I have kids just like you, a high school senior, and others. And you know what? The most important thing about this is that being seniors, this is a major milestone, but it's also a scary time because you have been mommy and daddy and everybody been taking care of you. But now it's time to separate that, not have mom and dad taking care of you, but take responsibility and get ready to move forward. College. For many of you, just like I mentioned, military, vocational school, trades, it's great. We just have something in mind. We talked about love and compassion. But one thing I'm gonna share a small message with you, because each and every last one of us are sometimes caught up in this because we just don't understand. The title of my message today is called Know Yourself, Love Yourself Before You Share Yourself. So, I'm gonna start off with this. A lot of us wanna be just like our friend. A lot of us wanna be like celebrities we see on TV. A lot of us wanna be like somebody else that we're not going to be. I want you to know, first of all, that each and every last one of you, all of us, are a masterpiece. We are one masterpiece. We born in our own way. We got our own strengths. We got our own weaknesses. We got our own talents. We got our own treasures. And we need to figure out who we are before we even share ourselves with anybody. So, each and every last one of you, you know how we put this persona on that I'm cool, I'm this, I'm that. I ain't nothing wrong with being cool, I'm cool. Ain't nothing wrong with that. But know who you are. Deep down who you are. I mean, you know when you're shy, when you fear, when you're scared, when you need help, when you're this and that. Know yourself, know your strengths and weaknesses. And do not be afraid to reach out and ask for help. You got your teachers, you got your parents, you got your friends, you got everybody, you got each other. So, know yourself, really get a chance to know who you are. And once you know who you are, you truly know who you are, love who you are. Love who you are. You're a masterpiece. Love who you are. Love who you were born to be. Love me some me. That's what I'm talking about. You gotta love me some me. A lot of people gonna tell you that you cannot do this and you cannot do that. Guess what? You heard that song, The Four C's, right? Create, collaborate, commit with confidence. Commit with what?
Confidence.
Commit with what?
Confidence.
In everything that you do. Everything that you do. Create, collaborate, commit with confidence. Confidence is knowing that you can do things when everybody else tells you that you cannot do it. The first C, and I'm gonna get back to Sherry in a minute. The first C is create. Create. If you can see it here, if you can see it here, you can do it. If you can see it here, you can do it. You might not be able to see it with the physical eyes, but if you can see it here, you can do it. Don't let anyone tell you that you cannot do it. You all are the future leaders of tomorrow, but you gotta start acting like that today. So create, collaborate, just like I said, communication. Communicate with each other. Communicate with people that you look up to. Even communicate with people that you, just respect everybody. It's all about respect, right? It's all about respect. So communication is part of collaborating. But when we put our heart and soul into anything that we're gonna do, if we tell somebody and we're gonna do something, we must. The third C is commit. Woo. Commitment is a hard word, right? Commit to doing the best that you can for the next 6 weeks in school. Commit to having a plan when you leave high school. You gotta know today or tomorrow, hopefully today, what your plans are. Hopefully, there is no bad decision unless there is no plan. If there is no plan, we walk around like this. Have a plan. So create, collaborate, commit with. Come on, you guys gotta commit with. Can we get it a little bit louder? Commit with. Confidence is knowing who you are, not knowing who somebody else is. Confidence is being able to step forward when they call us. I need a leader here. Do I have any leaders out here?
Hallelujah. That guy.
Do I have a leader? Can you get a lady to the stage?
Yes.
Finish this one, but I want to. I got a very, very special set of guests coming up here. I mean, I love this group, and I think you guys are gonna love them. They're gonna do what we call a human video. There will not be one word said from them, but I guarantee that you will know every single word coming out their mouth. Let's put our hands together for I Am the Generation.
Hello, hello. Hi guys, hi seniors, hi class of 2016.
And believe it or not, we are a YouTube organization. So you can find our videos and everywhere we go, especially today, will be documented on our YouTube channel. So check us out. Yes, yes. Make sure you look good, do your hair, everything right. Yes, absolutely. So basically, what we do is we do spoken word, messages, testimonies. We do human videos, which we're about to do for you guys today, which I'm really excited to do. And so, yeah, check us out, guys. We're on everything you can imagine. On Twitter, Tumblr, Pinterest, Instagram. We're on all these different social medias. We've got Periscope. And so, yeah, check us out, guys. But I'm really excited. Today, we're going to show you something about a teenager going through brokenness. And I don't know if any of you guys have ever felt broken any time in your life throughout your high school career. But at one time or another, we've all felt that way. And we're going to show you something about how being broken can be turned around, because there's a light always at the end of every tunnel. There is always light at every tunnel. So we're really excited and have the honor to be able to do this for you guys today. Thank you guys so much. And you guys, congratulations, class of 2016. Yeah.
Better have a wheel car, every way he will call. They hurt just like me, work just
I know we can do better than that. Let's give them another round of applause. The key takeaway, can I get a little more vodka here? The key takeaway is, regardless what the situation or circumstances that you might be going through or might appear to be going through, it only requires what we call a refocus, redirection. And you know, just, I call it the see it, theory. Remember to see it. Confidence, energy, and drive. If you got the confidence in what you set your mind to, you got the energy, and you got the drive, we stay on track. Because I mentioned to you earlier that each and every last one of you are masterpieces. And with being a masterpiece, each and every last one of you has a destiny that you have to fulfill. And fulfilling your destiny, sometimes we get stuck in what we call destination disease. High school is just a destination. The next step for the journey, college, military, job, that's a destiny that you have to fulfill that one in order to reach your destiny. One thing that I have not mentioned to this school or any administration folks is two of the lucky seniors in this school, the J.C. Cooley is going to get two scholarships to you. Oh, yeah. We're going to get two scholarships away this year. And the criteria will be coming. Who won a scholarship? Wow. Who do not want a scholarship? Stand up. Hey, scholarship, regardless of whether you got a full ride or where you're going in life, a scholarship kind of makes that path a little easier. But in order to get one, I'm going to tell you, remember, my departing message for you guys is called the AIP. And the H stands for aspire. Aspire to me is you see something and you want to achieve that, right? So we aspire to be the best that we can be. Or we aspire to go to college. We aspire to being an actor or whatever you aspire to be. Most of the time when we aspire, we are inspired by something, someone, some type of activity. Let me tell you about inspire. Make sure you pick and choose your role models carefully. Everything that you see on TV is not a hot, cranked up beat. I know a lot of actors, a lot of stars, a lot of this and that. I work with them all the time. It ain't always like that. So pick and choose your role models carefully. So your aspire is based on inspire, but it requires, for anything to get done, you got to perspire. That takes us back to aspiration comes from inspiration, but it requires perspiration. We got to work for everything that we do. And seniors, you have earned it. Stay on path to your destiny. Not destination, destiny. I want to thank Mr. Lilly, the school, the seniors, for allowing me and my friends, Hashimi, I don't see him around. I am the generation, of course yours truly, J.C. Cooley. Thank you very much. And I will be giving away two scholarships again to two lucky seniors at this school. Thank you very much.
This Mr. Cooley will be, I'll take him up, we'll meet with Mr. Murrow, and we'll figure out what we need to do to make that happen. But Mr. Cooley's been very kind because of your behavior and the reception he gets here that he's doing this. And that's a really big thing. I appreciate what you've done this week, except for Kyle. But you know, Kyle will be up here speaking one of these days. I'll be like, oh Lord. So thank you very much. Yes.
Can I give away some things if it's okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Where's Kyle at? Can Kyle come out to the stage?
The purple one. It's Kool-Aid.
But you gotta come on stage. Tell me a little about Cal. What are your plans after high school?
Take over the world.
How you gonna do that?
With the help of my peers, anything's possible.
He's a bad thing.
So anything possible?
Anything's possible.
All right.
Take it to the young leader. That young lady right there. Yes. You gotta come up and get it. Hey, what's wrong with the seniors? You guys walking real slow. You guys wanna stay, in high school another year?
You ain't got nothing. Confidence. You need confidence. Confidence is key. Confidence is
like. I'm going after high school.
I'm going to go to college.
Which college?
UCSB.
Y'all ready? Woo!
All right, give a round of applause. Y'all ready to say it? That's what I'm talking about. Two more.
I hope I got the right size.
What's next out here?
Yes, okay. This is it, Mr. Lilly, I promise.
All right.
Okay, before I get your t-shirt, you gotta tell me your name.
I'm Golton.
Golton! You guys know Golton?
I know Golton!
What are your plans after high school?
After high school, I'm gonna become an electrician.
I love it! How you plan on becoming an electrician?
To a 4-year program, and then after the first year, I'll start being paid on the job, and the program is like half of the month you're in school and half of the month you're in work, so you're constantly learning new things and applying it every time you go out.
I like that. Hey, listen up, I'm gonna be, you know what he just talked about vocational school, in a sense. That's how I started. I started out from a vocational school. I wasn't quite ready for college in the beginning. Vocation school got me there, military got me there, and I'm finishing up my PhD. You guys can do the same thing as well. Thanks a lot, guys.
You're next.
Gabby,
what is your intention?
I'm gonna go to a 2-year college.
Need to have pumpkins.
I like that. Hey, just as long as you got a pass, you can get there, right? Let's give everybody a round of applause. Hey, I want to bring my kids back on the stage. I want to bring them back out on the stage. Hey, can we give them another round of applause? I love you guys. I hope to see you guys again real soon. Thank you.
Okay, magician, you are dismissed.